I just wanted to present to you today an idea and a concept that we have been working on at our studio, which looks at using steel as a method to do high-rise construction, which is also modular, as well as in some aspects, hopefully, and we're working on this very, very, very feverishly, affordable. So I just wanted to sort of, you know, go through this entire journey of what it's been for us to just start dabbling with the idea of designing with steel, with, of course, the Indian context in the background. So when we look at why we look at steel frame construction or why we use steel frames, as an architect practicing in India, you find that it's mostly used if it's high rise. If we have like an industrial or a warehouse building, you know, there's a no-brainer. We look at how we can then have a pre-engineered building, which essentially is a building that's made of steel. In residential buildings, we have some light gauge steel construction that we do engage in. And in a lot of temporary structures, which look at like pavilions or things that don't necessarily need a structural sign-off, then we're very happy to use steel. Because when it starts looking at, you know, having to making sure that, you know, something that's very parametric or very fluid requires structural stability, as you've heard several speakers speak before me, this has been a challenge for us to try and pull off here just as yet. So when we quickly start looking at just like the pros and cons, and this is just the way we went through our own sort of design iterative process of ruling in and ruling out where and how we can use steel, we find that the only real advantage that, you know, we can sell to people is that this is super quick. It's going to be really fast to construct, and a lot of things are going to be prefab, made off-site, and then brought on-site. So then it sort of, you know, saves on your construction time frame, and your construction management at site becomes that much more streamlined. But apart from that, we are looking at, you know, the advantage of things being very flexible, being modular, looking at aspects of seismic resistance and how, you know, the structure could then be, you know, earthquake proof, as well as looking at ready-made structural sections which can then take any sort of shape and, you know, jointing and joining and mechanisms that then bring it together in a form that could then be very perhaps exciting or fluid or different. But the disadvantage that we always find that when we try to bring this idea to the market is the first thing they talk about is the susceptibility to fire. And the questions that we start getting asked are like, what are we going to do in terms of, you know, fire rating this building? Or how is it that we're going to like make sure that the building is not going to, you know, be prone to catching fire very easily. I also come from a very sort of humid environment. I'm from like the south and on the coast. So we do come across a lot of queries about what are we doing to, you know, make sure that the structure is going to be rust proof. So this is, again, something that we have to deal with coming from, you know, coastal or marine environments. So I think this is where, as architects and as designers, we're inspired by the possibility of steel. I mean, sure, we all wind up having that first pre-engineered, very boring industrial building which needs, like, you know, a large span structure, which is not hugely imaginative, but this is kind of where we would really like to sort of, you know, be living in this little realm of possibilities in terms of what steel can do. And I still remember very, very vividly visiting this building, and I think this is the Milwaukee Art Museum. And it has been designed with members that can move. So the building actually flaps at noon. And this, to me, when I first heard this, it was designed by Santiago Calatrava. So obviously, the engineering as well as the architecture kind of moves seamlessly in this building to be able to actually open up that structure, which is like a wing. So it just opens up and it flaps in the middle of the day. So, you know, obviously, you're inspired by the possibilities of doing stuff like this, because this is what the material is actually capable of. But then we wind up doing a lot of stuff like this. So this is our reality. So we wind up doing, you know, industrial buildings which have the long span, which have all the other advantages that steel can bring to the table. This is one of my first few Indian examples of, you know, working with steel after, like, you know, imagining and dreaming Calatrava. So this is one of our factory projects where we looked at doing a large scan structure. I'm sure all of you are super familiar with pictures like this. I'm not going to dwell on this very long. But what I wanted to also talk about was this concept that we are trying to develop. And we are looking at how we can bring in a high-rise structure which looks at a very modular grid format and try to incorporate this as a steel building so that then we can promote these with our clients as something that we can build very quickly, very fast to kind of erect on site, as well as have that flexibility and the advantage of being sustainable. So I think these are the kind of pros that we're trying to look at, you know, building up when we bring these ideas to clients. So this, for example, is a concept that we worked on for a high-rise school. I wouldn't really call it very high-rise. I mean, since we started and put this on our drawing boards, it's a 9-storied school. We completed a 27-story school in Bombay and in RCC. So, you know, by the time we went through the process of designing this, convincing the client, doing all of that, the 24-storied RCC structure is done. So, you know, this is the reality. And very often, this is what happens, is like when we bring this idea to the client, by the time we kind of go through the engineering process, get everything on board and get it off ground, they've somehow decided, "Ene chahiye, to conventionally karte hain," you know, that kind of, let's just switch back to what we're used to doing. So that's a massive challenge for us as designers when we start working on projects with steel. So yeah, on this particular project, we were looking at a very sort of aggressive timeline in terms of getting it built. The only reason that the people who were developing the school agreed to go with steel was not because of all the other advantages that I was trying to like talk to them about in terms of modularity and you know, sustainability, or it was just purely speed of construction. Because on a project like this, when they decide to launch a school, they need a very quick sort of turnaround towards the next academic year. And that becomes the time frame within which everything needs to happen. And we get mandates where they say, for example, it doesn't matter if the insides are not finished, but the outside and the overall shell of the building needs to be done in order for us to be able to even market a school. So purely on the merit of being able to, you know, deliver this project within a 6-month time frame, which is what was promised, we got the go-ahead to go ahead and, you know, explore the opportunity of working with steel on this. So I'll just quickly explain the idea of modularity and flexibility and the way in which we wanted to apply it here. So as I said, why steel? Modular, flexible, and on this particular project, we were looking at stacking 3 different types of schools within 3 different towers. So the project programming was also complex. So we had like a CBSE, an ICSE, as well as an IGCSE school on board. So the question of changing, you know, one building within the same footprint, the modularity was only possible if we looked at something that would give us that flexibility, which would work with the idea of some kind of like a structural system, but the walls could then sort of, you know, be so somewhat very, very independent and sort of become, by the way, very secondary to the entire nature of what the building intended to do. So in terms of steel application here, we looked at, of course, a very rectilinear built form, which had like a very regular rectangular grid. And all the columns here were envisioned to be steel. We did look at like flooring systems and also the flooring, the flooring systems also here were looking at not having every floor filled in, because as I said, the program was changing every 3 floors. So we were looking at having slightly taller than normal spaces. So you know, all of this flexibility was only possible without having very large beams or very large, you know, kind of structural elements with steel. So obviously we went overboard on trying to, you know, engineer the fire protection, what we were using vermiculite sprays and the intumescent paints, making sure that we had the gypsum paneling, making sure that everything was, you know, fireproof. So all of this was kind of built into the design. We did look a lot at in terms of the flexibility of having floors as well as services, because again, as I said, the requirement here was not to have everything built on day one. It should look complete on day one, but you know, we would go on adding services, adding classrooms, adding program to the entire building. And this was again possible with, you know, having having beams through which we could then run our services. So again, this became like a natural choice for us. In terms of flooring, we did a combination of a composite slab as well as some decking floors, which is like plain cement slurry poured on top. So we had an entire system that we kind of worked with in terms of the structure to be able to make this idea happen. These are the spaces that we wanted to keep open, for example, on one particular floor, so that you had the ventilation as well as the movement of air and light that would then make these classrooms feel nice and airy. And these spaces were changing every three floors because we were trying to do three programmatically different buildings. Some of the visuals on site. I think everything that we do from our studio tends to be very, sustainable. So obviously we looked at the idea of having, evaporative cooling areas, as well as having, large fans that would then make sure that we have the kind of ventilation that was brought into these sky corridors, if you could call them that, and sky atriums. Just in overall, so as you can see, we used very simple material, prefab sort of facade elements, which would then change depending on where we wanted them, along with a combination of glazing on the facade. So this is the kind of idea that we had. The corners were all areas where we had the ventilation coming in to be able to allow the air moving through and have like the lighting and ventilation come through. So just some other quick shots of how we were looking at executing this idea. In terms of sustainability as a program, I think this is something that we do build in along with the idea that building with steel itself is inherently sustainable and has a high renewable content. We were looking at how we can have passive systems of air towers, ventilation through like high velocity fans, as well as what it meant to have like, energy efficient systems and having a renewable component on site. So again, this comes back to like how we are loading the roof and how we're designing the roof to be able to harness energy as well as keep the building cool at the same time through the addition of green spaces. So this then brings us to a very practical application of what we took the same similar modular idea, the idea that the structure itself is made of steel and the walls can then be anything which is an exterior grade material, which is essentially what we were trying to do as an application idea for the school, where we took it towards a smaller, much more simple exhibit which we presented at a sustainability festival which was conducted in the city of Chennai. So here we wanted to work with the idea that steel is the framework. This is what will support all the materials, but the infill material could really be anything. And we wanted to promote sustainable materials or reuse materials and materials with high recycled content. So we were looking at panels of bamboo. We were looking at ideas of having weathered steel. We were looking at some, post-consumer or post-industrial materials, like we looked at some cycle chain scraps, we were looking at agri-fiber boards, anything that could then be like a bagasse board, for example, or a high-density fiber board. We also looked at ideas of showcasing other materials. So we did have like our decking sheets, which we would use if we were going in for like, the floor constructions, as well as having, some ideas of what it would be to have carpets or to have WPC. And of course we had glass. So this was our basic palette that we were working with. And again, working with the idea that you have a steel structure and you have all these little infill panels that we put together. The challenge on this was that the sustainability pavilion came to us as a project 3 days before it had to be put up on site. So we had 3 days to design, to build, and to execute this project. And that, I think, truly demonstrated to us that, the possibility of this material is really something that really needs to be harnessed. So this was the overall design of the pavilion that we came up with. As you can see, it's fairly simple. Looking at just a grid work, which is like erected out of steel, some solar panels on top, and then the walls, which then become panels or partitions, which we're using renewable or recycled material. This is kind of how we did it. It was too small for us to go in for, you know, bolts and having very complicated structures. So we did go in for a weld, which we understand is not ideal. But for this scale, it worked. And for the time frame, it worked. So this was it being constructed off-site. So a quick mock-up just to make sure that all the joints were working. Some of our material panels that were then mocked up with bamboo. And here you can see the colored glass. And then the kind of medley of all the materials coming together to forming those facades, to forming those exterior walls that we were looking at. Here you can see the cycle chain scrap. And here you can see some other punched metal, and you can see the weathered steel. This is the overall pavilion. It was transported to site on a small little chota hathi. So it was like very quick and very easy to sort of bring to site and assemble. The solar panels being installed. And yeah, that's the final product. So So I think the idea here was to just explore the concept of having steel as a very quick and modular sort of building mechanism, not to go down the Calatrava route and do something where, you know, we would fall in our faces and, you know, have huge, huge learning curves or have huge difficulties in execution, design, and erection on site. Rather look at something that would be modular, a sort of solution in the Indian context to try and bring about the same idea. For example, is something that we're working on for affordable housing. So we are looking at what it would mean to have really quick, affordable homes put up with a very, very similar format, which look at sustainable, quick, easy to construct modular homes that we can then deliver at like a cost and time advantage. So that's the idea I wanted to present. Thank you.